Welcome to the Humiseal booth here at Electronica Productronica India. Delighted to be joined by David Greenman. Great to see you again, Dave.
And you, Trevor.
Yeah. So this is one of your main markets down here. Of course, you've recently opened your own factory producing materials. But the thing we want to talk about today is a new emerging product you're working on called SEC, which stands for Sharp Edged
Coverage.
Tell us a little bit about this product and why you developed it.
Yeah. Okay, so we've been conscious with the ever-increasing packing densities of surface mount boards, the narrowing of the tracks, the closeness of the tracks, and more importantly, the square components that are now on surface mount. And one of the things we've seen is that unless you put several layers on, the square components, the sharp edges, the corners, are not coated sufficiently.
Right.
So that can lead with the low solids flux, no clean flux as they call it, that can lead to dendritic growth across the top of the coating that we've seen. So when we saw this occurring, we decided we had to develop a new product. And that new product is our SEC, Sharp Edge Coverage. And we've been doing that for the last 2 years. It's taken quite a bit of work.
Right.
And it's a product, we have two versions at the moment, a polyurethane and a synthetic rubber.
Okay.
And that's from our classic range. And we're hoping by the end of the year that we'll have a UV version, 100% solids, UV curable.
Wow. Okay. So that'll cover everything else then.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So explain to us a little bit how it actually works, the coating. How does it manage to stay around the edges and not stay uniform across the board?
So what we've done, we, as I've said, we've taken a couple of our classic products. We've modified them into a higher viscosity gel-like product that when it's applied, it thins, so the viscosity drops to allow it to be applied. That allows it to land on the board, and then it returns to its original gel-like consistency.
Right.
So, but before that, it levels out. So you get an even coating, but you get good sharp edge coverage.
Interesting. So basically, it wets across the board normally like a coating, but then it congeals around the edges essentially.
The whole product regains its higher viscosity,
right,
and forms those nice fully coated sharp edges,
right.
And we've proved this with cross sectioning, and our favorite test method is to power up a board, put it into a 4% salt solution equivalent to the sea, power it up at 24 volts, and we see zero defects
or leaks.
Zero current flow,
yep.
And zero bubble, you know, zero...
Wow. And so where specifically are you getting the most interest for this type of application?
We're aiming it at two markets. We're aiming it at the white goods market, because they're putting more electronic boards into their equipment, especially things like wet vacs, where you get a higher level of moisture, washing machines, dishwashers, but also obviously at the EV market.
Yes,
because now with the ever increasing number of boards in electric vehicles, and the environments they're putting into them. Some of them are outside of the actual compartment. In the old days, it would be attached to the engine and engine management unit. Now it's on the side of the batteries or at the back of the vehicle where the motor drive motors are. So that's the sort of area we're looking at.
And so is the automotive industry opening up a bit more to the idea of conformal coating?
Absolutely. And also, the good thing from our point of view, they're even now thinking of going back to cleaning.
Really?
Because cleaning before coating,
yes,
is something that we've preached about for a long time.
Yes.
But we've had to accept that there are companies that use low solids flux. And we have products also that will function over that.
Right.
But one of the things a lot of clients don't realize is that when you use a lead-free flux,
yeah,
it, at the higher process temperatures, it vitrifies.
Mm-hmm.
Goes glass-like.
Right.
Then when you put your conformal coating over, especially 100% solids UV curable,
yep,
you can get, and if you've got a UV coating that is, that has good chemical resistance,
mm-hmm,
it's, you get a difference in in coefficients of thermal expansion.
Right.
And you can get cracking of the coating.
Cracking.
And that obviously lets, yep, contaminants in.
Contaminants in, that's true.
So, you know, we've done a lot of work on that. We've got coatings that can now go on the top of vitrified flux.
Mm-hmm.
It's got enough flexibility.
Right.
But
how do you achieve that? By introducing an elastometer into the coating mix?
Yeah, it's a different base resin.
Mm.
And it's formulated to be more flexible.
Yeah.
But the problem then is you've got less chemical resistance.
Right.
So it's a trade-off.
Okay. Now, last time we spoke about the cleaning issue, I mean, I think there's only about 20% of people were cleaning before coating. Has that risen? Has that gone up recently?
We are seeing an increase.
Mm.
When we talk to some of the major cleaning process companies,
mm-hmm,
chemical companies, we're hearing that they are getting more and more inquiries about cleaning before coating.
Yeah.
And again, that's because of the packing densities.
Yeah.
You don't want flux around your components when you're putting a coating on the top.
Yeah.
Because by applying a conformal coating, you're not only keeping contaminants out,
mm-hmm,
but you're trapping contaminants underneath.
Yes.
And again, that can lead to dendritic growth, mm-hmm, failures,
mm-hmm,
independent faults.
Right.
And a higher warranty cost.
Right. Right. Wow. So when are you expecting? I mean, I believe this SEC material is in beta trials at the moment.
Correct.
When are you expecting it to be available and ready to roll out?
We are looking around November.
Mm-hmm.
We'll certainly be talking more about it at Productronica in Munich.
Yeah, okay.
And we will hopefully be doing some live demonstrations there.
Excellent. Well, we'll look forward to that.
You're more than welcome to come along and see what we're doing, Trevor.
Yeah, will do. Okay. All right. Well, wish you the best of luck with the remaining trials for it, and we'll catch up again in a couple of months.
Absolutely. Okay. Thank you so much for coming along.
Thank you.